You're listening to the Magnetic Boss Podcast, where badass entrepreneurs come together to share authentic conversations. We're ditching the cookie cutter approach to building a business and valuing collaboration over competition. I'm your host, Calandra Martin, boy mom, coffee obsessed coach, speaker, and leader. I help women radiate their brilliance in the online space and create magnetic brands. We are here to have fun, do work we love, and enjoy the ride. Now let's dive in. Welcome back to the Magnetic Boss Podcast. It feels surreal to be saying to you that this is the last episode of season one here on the Magnetic Boss Podcast. I honestly look back on 2020 and it feels like it was just yesterday that I decided to launch this podcast, that I followed my calling to share with you in this way and to be producing this content for you every single week. I remember looking back when I decided to make this podcast, the first thought that I had was, how am I ever going to talk that much? How am I ever going to show up and create content every single week? And here we are 40 weeks later at the end of 2020, which, let's face it, it's been a wild, wild ride. And season one is wrapping up. So this is, before we dive into today's episode, I just want to let you know that this is the last episode of 2020. So you can expect season two to release January 6th. In the new year, in 2021, we will continue to be sharing episodes every single week. We're going to have some really juicy and exciting interviews with experts in the online space, other industry leaders that are really, really incredible. I'm so excited to share some of the lineup with you as we enter into 2021. And you'll also expect to see, of course, or hear rather, episodes from me sharing some insider secrets when it comes to branding, design, social media marketing, and really creating a name for yourself when it comes to promoting your business and being recognized. So with that being said, please make sure that you are subscribed to the podcast. That way you get the updates when the next episode and the first episode of season two is released. And if you're not already on the mailing list, make sure that you get on there as well. And I'll be sending out an announcement and a little bit of an exciting launch announcement with some fun giveaways as well. So make sure that you are on that list. The link is in the description of this episode. Okay, so to bring it back down, I'm going to ground myself here because I want to share with you on today's episode how to start looking at your personal brand for 2021. I know that this is on everybody's mind right now. What is the new year going to look like? What is it going to bring us? There's been a lot of upheaval in 2020. So of course, we all have our sights set on bigger and better and more aligned, amazing things for the new year. If you didn't listen to the Set Your End of Year Expectations episode, go listen to that one first. It's really important for you to kind of listen to these in order because I am going to piggyback off of some of the concepts that I shared in that episode. But today, I want to dive into personal branding because this is my jam. It's my favorite thing to talk about, and it's applicable to every single business. Your personal brand is really a representation of who you desire to be and how you show up in the world through your business, right? Your business is the vehicle. It is the driving force in how you support people and how you make change, how you problem solve and share your brilliance. And I know that your brilliance is completely different from somebody else's brilliance, even if that somebody is in the same industry as you. And what truly sets you apart is your personal brand, is who you are being on a regular basis, building that consistency, building that know, like, and trust with your audience. These are all so important when it comes to becoming recognized and memorable and sought out. This is what I want you to be able to do and accomplish and feel in 2021. So I'm going to walk you through a little bit of an exercise again today. I love giving you tangible things to work with. So if you're loving this episode, take a screenshot, tag me on Instagram. Let me know what your word of the year is, which I'm going to dive right into right now for you. So with today's exercise, I want you to be thinking about when you look back, or look ahead rather, on your big vision for the new year, right? 2021 is right around the corner. What do you desire? And there is no right or wrong answer with this. Your desires are your own. And that's the beautiful thing about entrepreneurship, is you get to write the rule book. You get to decide when you jump and how high you jump and how quickly you do it. So I want you to be thinking about what your word of the year might be. This is something that I started doing a couple of years ago in my business. I heard somebody else talking about choosing a word of the year. And initially I thought that it was a little bit silly because I had so many different words, right? Initially, when I first went through this exercise, I thought, well, I have about 25 things that I want to accomplish in the new year. So how do I choose just one, right? And this is why this exercise is really powerful, because your word of the year serves as an anchor, as a reminder of your bigger vision, of where you are going, so that when you get caught up in the hustle and bustle, when you are feeling stagnation in your business, which, let's face it, that happens to all of us, and when life just gets in the way, or our minds get in the way of what it is that we're trying to create, you will have this word to remind you of what you are here to do. So some examples of words of the year that you might lean into just to help you start brainstorming. And maybe you make a list of 20 and you narrow it down from there. Really feel into your body with this and start to recognize what feels good. Trust your intuition. Again, there's no right or wrong answer. And your word might evolve throughout the year. I know that that has happened to me before, where I've set an intention, I've created a word of the year, and then a few months into the year, I decided that that wasn't in alignment anymore. So don't think that this is something that you are making a legal agreement on. Just use this as a tool and a reminder for yourself. Okay, so a couple of ideas for you. Abundance, growth, expansion, joy, kindness, gentle, presence, renew. Do any of those pique your interest? And if not, that's totally fine. Make your own list, brainstorm your own word of the year, and really allow this to give you guidance on the next exercise, which is to start thinking about who you desire to be in 2021. So of course, you could think about the strategy behind your business all day long. Maybe you have really big goals for 2021. It could be launching a podcast. It could be growing your email list. It could be launching a new program or a product or an offer. It could be reaching an income goal. All of those things are beautiful and amazing, but in order to get to that place, you have to be able to embody the version of you that does those things. So when you're thinking about your personal brand in 2021, you have to know what your grand vision is, what you desire to create, which we talked about in the most recent episode for your end of the year expectations. You want to be setting your expectations as well for 2021. And then to really think about who you have to be to make that happen, to be able to manifest that into your reality. Because if you go into the new year blindly, you're going to really open yourself up to spinning out in overwhelm or throwing spaghetti at the wall in your business and not knowing what direction to go in. So I want you to use these words and these intentions as your compass for where your personal brand will go. And once you lay this foundation, and this is some of the work that I do with my one-on-one clients, where we really look at their business from an internal perspective and an external perspective. So you want to lay the foundation for these internal pieces. What do you desire in the new year? Who do you desire to be? And then how do you reflect that to the world? How do you share that with the world? This might look like your visual brand. It might look like the messaging that you're sharing. It might look like the ways that you are creating connections in your business. There's so many opportunities for you to share your personal brand, but you first have to understand what that personal brand is. And with that being said, something that's so important for you to keep in the front of your mind is that it's also just as important for you to keep it simple, right? You really want to have this groundwork in place, but I don't want you to stay here. I don't want you to be spinning in circles with, well, what if my personal brand was this? And what if I did this? And what if I showed up this way? That's not really going to move the needle forward in your business. What is going to move the needle forward the most, what is going to give you that momentum, that push, that energy that is going to allow you to become magnetic, is keeping things simple. It's one of my favorite ways to teach business is in a simple way. And to really remind you that simplicity is the key to sustainability. And there's always an and in business. I feel like I'm always giving you a concept and then building off of that. And you have to give yourself grace. It's so, so crucial as business owners for us to be flexible, to be open to the idea that things aren't always going to go the way that we imagine they would, for our expectations to be shifted, for us to evolve. That is just human nature. And you can't take the human aspect out of your business. Of course, it's really important to look at your business as a business and not put all of the weight and the pressure on yourself as a human. But keep in mind that you are the human running the business. So of course, when it comes to your personal brand, you're going to evolve, you're going to shift. And that is actually okay. It's more than okay, because every time you shift, every time you up level or redirect your energy to the right place, the place that feels good, that feels in alignment, the easier it gets. You're allowed to change, but make sure that that change is simple. Make sure that you are keeping in the forefront of your mind what you desire to feel, who you desire to be. And those are the things that are going to help you create that end result. So before we enter into 2021, and I know that your schedule is probably really busy, you're probably spending a lot of time with family, which, a little reminder here, keep your boundaries in place. Make sure that you're taking care of yourself. Protect your energy as you need to. We all have to be mindful of this during the holiday seasons. But I want you to slow down for just a minute and look at your personal brand from the perspective of the internal and the external, and choose your word of the year in order to help you really lay the foundation for everything that you do in your brand. Now, if you are looking for the next steps from this, if you are taking the time to do the journal prompt, but you need a little bit more and you're ready to dive in, I invite you to go take the brand personality quiz. This is my free quiz. You can find it right on my website, calandramartin.com. And this is going to give you a lot of insight. It's going to help you understand the complexities of personal branding by giving you a personality type that I've honestly heard amazing feedback from. I've had people tell me that it was the most accurate personality quiz that they've taken. And it's really going to help you dial in the next steps in showing up with your personal brand and how to really translate that into the online space and really in the world and who you are being. So going back to that prompt that I gave you on who do you desire to be? So again, you can take the quiz on my website, calandramartin.com, and make sure that you are staying in touch. As I mentioned in the beginning of this episode, you can follow me on Instagram at calandra.martin. This is the last episode of 2020, and we will be back for season 2 starting on January 6th, which is a Wednesday. So make sure you're subscribed if you're loving the show, and I will see you in the new year. I'm sending you so much love.